just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Oklahoma tees up the ball as we get ready for the opening kickoff. He's to the 20, at the 30, and he's taken down at the 36. The Longhorns, having a wide receiver like this, I think sometimes it even helps a young quarterback, because this kid goes out there, he works hard in practice every day, and I think he really lifts the whole offense.
I think he does. I think he's almost like having an extension from the coaching staff into the locker room with the players. So he's a guy that makes big plays, but I think he takes it upon himself to be able to help out with some of the other receivers, make sure that they're all on the same page, understand the route adjustments, understand everything that goes on with being a wide receiver and the importance of blocking. So all the little things that seem to add up and make big plays, I think this guy totally understands his responsibility being a go-to player.
And he hits him hard at the 46. That makes it second and two. He is drilled at the 38-yard line.
That's the beauty of running play action against zone coverage. In man, the defender has his eyes on the guy he's covering. But in zone, the defender's looking right at the quarterback. That's why that play action worked so well for a first down. They weren't sure if it was a run or a pass.
Fires quick, he catches another. And down he goes at the 33-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 22-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Right.
Tackled after a decent pickup. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
And two.
Brought down at the 10-yard line. Bring him down at the 3. He scrambled. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next down.
Got him for a loss.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
This one should be makeable. Texas could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up, and the field goal is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Gathered in at the 6. Tackle at the 31-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Quickly incomplete.
I like the scheme the defensive coordinator came up with here. They were all over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 31.
Green nine.
He He's tackled at the 43-yard line. Taken down around the 48-yard line. Got an opening. Gets out to around the 38.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
The middle. Tackle at the 30.
That's a deep hit on the brother. That makes it second and two.
And he's taken down right around the 22-yard line. He's got another one. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Here's the eighth play of the series. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. Is out to the tailback on the screen. And he's tackled at the 11. Looking for six, and he got it. Touchdown.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
He makes the PAT. A 10-play, 67-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Taken at the 5. Looking for the corner. He's out to the 30. Down the sideline. Here he goes. Inside the 30. And they're going to bring this one all the way back. Touchdown. Boy, is this kid electric. Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Taken from the 3-yard line. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
Brad, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
It's complete. And they make the stop at the 43.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
Kill. 4, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3.
gets it out to maybe the 43-yard line. To that quickly. Knocked out of bounds at the 30-yard line.
This is a great pitch and catch combination, and they hook up here for a big-time game.
Nice run, and he's brought down. And Herbie, we got a guy down after that play. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He gets out to about the 14-yard line. Rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
And a quick throw. Tackle made at the 2-yard line.
That's a D of 12 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 5-yard line. Just throws this one away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
This is the 10th play of this drive. The Sooners lost a player earlier. Herbie, this is a big blow to this team. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Oklahoma can tie it up here with this kick. He gets it up, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
They line up to kick this one away. He'll take it from the 2. He's to the 20. Across the 30. And he's tackled at the 37. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
Give to the tailback, and he's met in the backfield. From their own 46-yard line, second down. He's going to be sacked.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Mike 20, Mike 20. Dog 4. No 4. No 4.
inside. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
So they run the ball on third and long, and it's stuck.
Well, Brad, here the offense is trying to surprise the defense with a run, but it didn't work.
And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Makes it out to about the 49. He's in trouble. Gonna go across the middle, caught, and down he goes at the 21. Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it.
That's a good game of 1 yard. That brings us second and 9.
Mike Green. Humble.
Check.
Green 15. Check 99.
He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Steps up. Fires out to his receiver. And he's level at the 8. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Mike 3. Black 5. Blue.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. Converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 27-yard line. Oklahoma's got people flying all over the field on defense right now.
Boy, they sure do. Right now, we're just seeing great defensive effort. They have a plan. They understand it. They're playing with great speed, and they're not giving up big plays. That's why they're playing well up to this point.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Complete. He's got room. He goes out of bounds. Right around the 28-yard line.
Tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
From their own 28-yard line, it's third down. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. They'll drop him for a loss. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little. Took him down hard. Oklahoma's coaching staff's always preaching the importance of finishing drives, and that's what they're doing right now.
Well, these players are obviously listening to that because it's nice to see this offense be able to move the football and then take advantage of opportunities. Right now, they have been flawless.
The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Oklahoma up 7 points. Slings it. Brought down at the 41. Steps out around the 36-yard line. They'll bring him down right around the 20. Sets them up for the first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
And they got him for a loss.
That might have actually been a situation where he should have kept it. The back didn't have any room to run.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. They get him in the backfield for a loss. Oklahoma is up 7. Just throws this one away. This isn't much more than an extra point. Oklahoma can make this a 2-possession game with this field goal. Kicks away, and he's got it. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Good coverage by the kicking team. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
He's to the 10. He's to the 20. Makes it to the 24. They just did what they had to do there.
That was a big opportunity lost there for the defense, but they still have these guys pinned back pretty deep, so they can't back down now.
Zips it to the tight end. He's taken down at the 33.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle right around the 46-yard line. Tackled around the 49-yard line. That makes it 7-6. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. They'll line it up again on third down. It's caught, first down, and he's out of bounds. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Fights forward to about the 23. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Makes the grab past the marker. Run up the middle.
That brings him second and goal.
Touchdown, Longhorns. Nice job by the offense to get the final few yards to the end zone.
Yeah, they knew what play to call for in that situation and made it work.
Here's the point after to try to cut this to a three-point game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Texas is ready to kick it away. Taken at the five. He's to the 20. Makes it to the 22-yard line. The Sooners having everything going their way right now. They have put up 20 straight points on the board. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Oklahoma has a three-point lead. Passes to the back, incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. He's on the run. And they make the stop around the 28-yard line. Zips it left. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Throwing right. Got it. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown.
Great effort by the wide receiver. And not to take anything away from the quarterback, but the wide receiver made this play.
Brad, the quarterback and this wide receiver clearly have outstanding chemistry. Wide receiver is so open because it was a perfect route and the quarterback was able to time it up just perfectly.
And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 22. It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Great run, and he's brought down in the backfield.
That was just smash mouth, helmet to chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on their own 19. And he's tackled at the 21-yard line. Is out to the tailback on the screen. And he's taken down around the 32-yard line. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. And he's taken down at the 47. The Sooners are looking like they're unstoppable right now. They've just exploded in this game. I don't know if the defense can adjust or not.
Well, they have big playability all over the field, and this defense has got to make some adjustments to do a better job of trying to slow them down. I would recommend trying to put some more pressure on this quarterback by loading the line of scrimmage.
We're back for more action here in quarter number two. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Gets out to around the 38. Made at the 19-yard line. There's a strike complete. The 10, and he has his back, who's wide open. Rung up three touchdown tosses in the half.
Defense better make some adjustments, and they need to make them now because this passing attack is making a highlight film right now.
He makes the PAT. So a short three-play, 53-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. So the score now, 34-17. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From the 7, he gets out to about the 25-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Gets it out to about the 47-yard line. Here he goes. He gets out to about the 44-yard line. That's a gain of 9 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2. Tackled after positive yardage. And he might want it all here and does.
Here's a case of a quarterback so eager to make a play that he failed to see the danger of that attempt and nearly gave the ball away.
From the 39-yard line. Second down. He gets rid of this one.
Three down. Hey, Mike 20, Mike 20.
and he throws right away. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. And down he goes, right around the 8-yard line.
Number 31 makes the tackle at the 8-yard line. That will bring up second and 20.
Right 20, right 20. Shoot.
Gets to about the 5-yard line.
Just hard to stop. Once this young man gets on the move, it's highlight time.
And he converts the extra point. Texas lines up for the kickoff. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. A touchdown was the end result of their last drive, as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
It was a really nice drive too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
Nice run to the outside.
That's a genius seven on the play. That'll bring up second and three.
Gets to about the 41-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. He's at midfield. They'll bring him down right around the 48-yard line. Here comes the pressure. He's taken down at the 45-yard line.
Number 23 on the tackle.
Mike three.
Got it. And he goes down quickly. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. Tackle at the 32-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 32. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's tackled at about the 31. Stop at the 22-yard line.
Let's go. First down.
just gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Second and 10. Ball on the 22. Quick toss. And that one's incomplete.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
That makes it first and goal.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled around the 1 yard line. To buy some time. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. They weren't able to defend a quarterback scramble, and they give up six.
And he's one of those quarterbacks who can do this when he's close to the goal line. He'll pump fake, then take off, or he'll put his head down and crash it in. Anything goes with this guy.
And he hits the PAT. So a 14-play, 75-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He's taken down at the 27-yard line.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. Here's the halfback. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Maybe a yard on that draw play. That's going to bring up fourth down.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
At the 38. And what a game it's been for this quarterback, Kirk.
Well, it's been a fun afternoon because he's having a lot of success. And the reason is he's in tune with his receivers and they're really playing with a great rhythm. But let's also give credit to this offensive line. Every single time this defense has blitzed, they've been able to protect him and give him the time that he needs to be able to deliver the football downfield.
And to be sticking it to a rival is even more special. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Nice run there. Out of bounds at the 44.
Two, 20.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
He's tackled at the 36-yard line. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. And he carries the ball for a nice game. Quick out to his receiver. And he's taken down at the 48-yard line. Gets out to about the 45-yard line. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. Wants to go long and does. Incomplete.
Number eight, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and eight.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Makes it out to about the 33. Fakes the handoff. Defense coming. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. He scrambled. Looking for the corner. Tackle made around the 42-yard line.
The defense was just all over that play. It didn't fool anybody.
And we'll take a break while the injured players attended to. Second and long. Ball on the 48. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. He's scrambling. And now he's going to improvise. And down he goes at the 34-yard line.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and two.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Fires to the wideout, first down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Throws complete, and he's hit right away. Looking for his man, incomplete. They'll line it up again on third down. The Sooners quarterback down there on the sideline, and Kirk, you and I talked to him earlier this week, and he is really the main cog in this offense. Doesn't look like
like he's in that much pain right now. They need him back on the field before this one's over.
Get to that quickly. Brought down around the 6-yard line.
The offense gets a first down here. You got to give them some credit. But really, this is more about the defense. When a defense gets an offense to third down and medium, you've got to be able to put pressure on the quarterback, especially when they're passing the football. And try to get your own offense the ball back. And that time, they let their own offense down.
Quick strike, and he drops it. They're at the 6. It's second down. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over.
Here's the 12th play of the drive. Gives it to the back. Tackled for a loss.
The defense just met the blockers head on and drove them back straight into the runner.
That brings us fourth and goal.
Fourth down. This one should be makeable. Kicks away, and they tack on 3 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Fielded at the 9. He's out to the 30, at the corner, across midfield, inside the 30. He's finally tackled at the 16.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
Tackled after decent pickup. Bring him down at the 3-yard line.
That brings him 7
yards.
Touchdown, Longhorns. Score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
And he adds the extra point. A 4-play, 17-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The offense gets set to take the field. Last time out, they stuck it between the uprights for 3. Fires out to his wideout, and he's shoved out of bounds right around the 30. The middle for a nice game. Fires complete over the middle. He's taken down at about the 39-yard line. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. From their own 41-yard line, second down. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Makes
makes the grab and steps out right away.
That makes it first and 10.
They come out in a 5-wide set. Catches it, and that's all.
That's a game seven. That'll bring up second and three.
Scrambling around. He's wrapped up for the sack.
Call it a loss of 6 yards on the play. Third down.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. The Sooners wide receiver, we hope, can make a comeback and get back in this ball game. Went out with that injury a little bit earlier. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Trying to change the field position with his kick. Tackle made at the 18. These guys came up with a touchdown in their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another six on the board here. He's under pressure. What a tackle. That was going to be a touchdown.
Black five, black five.
He makes it to the 48-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. He zips it out to the left. He hauls it in and gets out of bounds. Here they go, first and goal, down by a couple of possessions. He's got it with room to run, and he tackles him hard at the two.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch, that's fun to see.
Scrambling, and they got it.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. And it seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
Fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. It's up, and he got it. Texas lines up for the kickoff. He just drills this one.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Oklahoma has put themselves in a great position now as they head into the second half.
Well, in the first half, we saw a lot of big playability and just a lot of an explosive approach by this offense. But remember, we'll see what happens here in the second half. This is a long way from being over.
Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's leveled at the 34.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
Passes to the back, incomplete. So the officials taking a look at this play to see if the receiver got a foot in bounds.
Regardless of the outcome of this review, I still think that this guy made an excellent catch.
Well, they get it right after the review. They call it a catch, and play will continue. Here. He's going to scramble.
He takes off. Dives forward.
Fires that quickly, incomplete. From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. Throw out to the receiver, and he's tackled at the 31-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game, and I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
Now he tries to buy some time. He gets sacked on the play.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
And he just gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. That's a loss of about three.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. They head to the locker rooms. This one is far from over. Oklahoma's got a 10-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Exciting first half there. It seemed like every time you turned around, there was another big play. Both of these offenses coming up with yards and chunks, and it's really paid off for them in the first half.
Yeah, and it's one thing for offenses to execute and get little plays here and there and continue drives, but it's really nice when you hit home runs. It's really nice to make it simple and say, all right, we're going to get about 50 right here. We're going to get about 30 right here. You know, the offense came simple. You know, great job playmakers making plays, breaking tackles, you know, spinning off players, making big gains. You know, listen, it makes offense very simple. There's no secret to it. If you got all explosive offenses that can do this, if you get big chunk plays, they're going to score a lot of points every single game.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
From the seven. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. He throws left, pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. To the 20, to the 10, touchdown Sooners. He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Made around the 39-yard line. He's on the run, and he's taken down at the 39. Setting up blockers or running backs. Got it on the screen. Inside the 30. And they make the stop right around the 26-yard line. And down he goes right around the 16-yard line. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, knocked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Handoff inside. Runs outside for a nice gain. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. The 7-yard line.
Couldn't get that additional yard he needed to keep the drive moving.
No, he was trying to muscle his way past those big guys, but they stood their ground.
You don't need three guesses to figure out what they're going to run right here on fourth and short.
Caught. Touchdown. And they're not ready to quit just yet.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Taken from the 3-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 25.
How was
was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
And that's his receiver who's wide open.
Tackle around the 34-yard line.
Makes it to the 47. Once and all, going deep. And a great catch downfield. Touchdown, Oklahoma. And he converts the extra point. Oklahoma, yet set to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
From their own 25-yard line, second down.
Kill, kill, kill!
They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line. Makes his way to about the 42. Run inside, stop quickly. A screen pass, gets it to the back, and they'll get him in the backfield.
That's a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it 3rd and 11.
Oh, it almost picked off, and that'll make it 4th down.
It was a good hold by the defense on 3rd down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
He's tackled at the 26. This receiver's been having himself a great game.
Well, Brad, he really has, and he's got the hot hand. And let's give some credit to the offensive coordinator, because he's smart enough to get the football to him and allow him to make these plays that's helping his offense out.
When one of your receivers can average 20 yards a catch, your offense is doing something right. And with this big lead, how many more chances will they take in the passing game?
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
He gets hit out of bounds around the 26-yard line. The receiver incomplete. It's 3rd and 11. Ball on the 26-yard line. He's taken down around the 44-yard line.
Mike 3! Mike 3!
quick out to his receiver.
And he is drilled at the 38-yard line.
Second and 15. Ball on the 38. He's tackled at the 49-yard line.
Number 16 brings him down.
He's got the tailback on another catch. That's a great tackle at the 48-yard line.
Number 96 makes the tackle at the 48-yard line.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Mike 3! Mike 3!
And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. The offense couldn't convert, and that's going to cost him the possession.
And the defense looked like they were expecting option on that play. Great job to pin him up and cause the turnover on downs.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
He makes it to the 48-yard line. He rifles it. And got him! The 10. Touchdown, and it ain't over yet. Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play. Brad, the quarterback and this wide receiver clearly have outstanding chemistry. Wide receiver is so open because it was a perfect route and the quarterback was able to time it up just perfectly.
And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he'll return this one from the 7. He's taken down at the 26-yard line.
The Longhorns coaching staff's got to be elated over on the sideline about what they plan to do with this wide receiver and the plans coming to fruition.
Absolutely, and they continue to be able to find ways to give him the football. That's the thing that's been probably most impressive, not just his ability, but how they've moved him around and gotten the football to him in different ways. It makes it very tough on the defense.
And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. His way out to about the 35. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. He steps out at the 37-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
But he can't hang on.
Number 28 was the intended receiver.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 37.
Mike 3, Mike 3. Pumble.
And they get the sack.
To me, that's on the quarterback. He's got to be able to recognize and use his eyes and vision to be able to see that the corner is coming on a blitz. The offense didn't do a good job of picking up the blitz, but the quarterback's got to be able to see that and make the throw quickly to get the ball before the corner can sack him.
The Sooners lost one of their key guys earlier to that injury, and unfortunately, I don't think he's going to play any more football today.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he's tackled at the 31. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Gives it off. Makes it out to about the 49. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at about the 35. Taken down right around the 12-yard line.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
Gets to about the 11-yard line. From the 11-yard line, it's second down. Hit before he could go anywhere. Touchdown, Longhorns.
Perfect call under these circumstances, confusing them with the option and then getting the football into the hands of the running back.
Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. And he hits the PAT. A nice 8-play, 60-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. Texas kicked this one off. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The Longhorns came into the second half. They looked like they were just going to cruise to a victory. Right now, they better turn it around or they could lose this lead.
You're right. I don't know what happened at halftime. Maybe they were worried about the press clippings after this game, but they better get things in order. They could end up losing this ball game.
So we're just about ready to return to action. Oklahoma holds a field goal lead. Quick strike to the receiver. He's to the 40, and they make the stop at the 47. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide out look. There's a strike complete, and he's shoved out of bounds right around the 44-yard line. That makes it second and two. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five wide set, and the defense counters with their dime look. He airs it out. Can't connect. And they just couldn't connect there on the long ball.
Well, that's one the quarterback wants back. He just had a little too much on that pass.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Pitch play to the left. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Mike three. passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in. Big stop by the defense. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Looks like he's going to run, and down he goes at the 42-yard line. To that quickly. They'll drop him for a loss. Complete. He's got room. Brought down around the 33-yard line. And they push him out at the 28. And he just gets rid of it. From the 28-yard line, second down. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Caught with room to work. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. Five wide. And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. A seven-play, 56-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Fielded at the four. He's tackled at the 22-yard line. The Longhorns defense really looked pathetic in that first half, Kirk, and now they're doing a nice job.
Well, obviously, they've made some adjustments after the first half, and it's paid off for them. I think right now they're tuned in to what this offense is trying to do, and I think they're also just playing with a little bit more of a chip on their shoulder.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure, but they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Fires it out. And he's level at the 27. That's a quick pass. Slings it. Very good tackle in space. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. Right around the 40.
That makes it first and 10. Mike three. Pumble.
Easy. Delta.
throws, and that one's going to hit the ground, incomplete.
Here's a case of a quarterback so eager to make a play that he failed to see the danger of that attempt and nearly gave the ball away.
From the 40-yard line, it's second down. Gets it, he's in space. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. Caught out in the open. He goes out of bounds. Right around the 8-yard line. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in.
Number nine was the intended receiver.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Bring him down around the 5-yard line.
That's a GD3 on the play.
Come on.
That makes it first and goal.
Yeah. Navajo! Navajo!
Throws it out and it falls incomplete. And this is the 12th play of the drive.
That brings him second and goal.
Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown. And that makes it 3 scoring tosses for him.
What I'm noticing more and more about this guy is he's very patient with the ball, and it's resulting in some nice scores, just like we've seen today.
Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this 5-receiver look. Slings it out there incomplete.
Number 80, the intended receiver away.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25. 5 guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Moves up in the pocket. Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled at about the 31. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. He scrambled. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Wow, partner, with the way these offenses are lighting things up, they're going to need some oxygen out there. As a matter of fact, the way they're playing, I might need some oxygen.
The
last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
He fights forward to about the 49. Oklahoma is up by three. Fires out quickly to the tailback. He's taken down at the 44-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes us third and three.
He gets to about the 31-yard line. Just throws this one away. From the 31-yard line, second down. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he is drilled at the 13. The middle.
That makes it second and six.
He's gobbled up in the backfield. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Oklahoma is up a field goal. Halfback's got it on the quick throw, and he hits him hard at the 12-yard line. Kicks away, and the field goal is good. All lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He's going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. The Sooners in front by six. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. He's wrapped up for the sack. Third and long, and this is where you earn your money if you're the offensive coordinator. He's under pressure. He wants it all. And he's tackled at the 23-yard line. Tackle made at the 12. Thank you.
gets forward to about the 10. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Stop. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Straight run, and he's brought down in the backfield. Unable to convert on fourth down, and the ball changes hands.
They tried to sneak a little counterplay by the defense. They weren't fooled that time. That's a great play to cause the turnover on down.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Oklahoma is up by 6. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. And he's hit hard immediately. Well, we get a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche? Gets out to about the 31. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Stop at the 28-yard line. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And he shoved out of bounds at the 16. In the open field, and he's taken down
at about the 7-yard line.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
He's scrambling, and he can't get away from the pressure. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
And here's another third down. Now he tries to buy some time. Ball is loose. Fumble. Picked up by the linebacker.
That just shows you how determined this defense is. Great play by the linebacker to come up with the ball after the fumble.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. Oklahoma with a 6-point lead. Brought down at the 6.
third down, 9 to go. Ball on the 6-yard line. He's going to air it long. And down he goes, right around the 42-yard line.
Well, you give up too many passes like that, and the game will be done before you know it. They cannot let these receivers get behind them.
Gains his way to the 43-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it 7-6.
Quick strike, and he drops it. And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. Just throws this one away. Five wide. Strike to his receiver, no good. Defense stiffens on fourth down, and the ball will change hands. The offense comes back out, and as I'm sure you'll remember, their last possession ended in a lost fumble.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Heading for the corner. Very good tackle in space. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Lost the ball. Fumble. Picks up the fumble. Not a good time to fumble the football.
And that guy feels horrible about it. He's got to forget about it. Go out there and play hard the next time they hit the field.
So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after review, they decide that this call should be reversed. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 50. Scrambling around. He's at the 40. And he tackles him hard at the 32. There's a strike complete. And he's level at the 16-yard line. Based on their last visit to the red zone, I'd expect them to take better care of the ball this time around. Biggest third down and long of the football game right here in the fourth quarter. He lets it go.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
Fourth down.
The kick is up, and it splits the uprights. Texas to kick. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 22-yard line.
Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for six that time.
You know, we still have a lot of time left in this game. It's not as if the offense can just take a knee three times and get out of here with a win. I still think they've got to be aggressive. At the same time, the quarterback's got to make good decisions and make sure that he and the running back secure that football. They cannot afford to turn it over.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. Oklahoma has a three-point lead. Feeds it to the back. Tackle at the 31-yard line. They'll get him for a loss. The lineman had a big push there to get in the backfield and bring him down.
And once he gets moving, there's no stopping him. This guy is so big and strong that he's almost impossible to block with one guy.
The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. He's tackled at the 46-yard line. This young quarterback's been a big factor today, Kirk.
Well, what's great about this offense is having a quarterback that can hurt you both running and throwing. And we've seen that today. But what we've seen today is his ability to get outside of the pocket and break contain to keep the play alive.
And for Texas, they've still got work to do to pull out this win, and it'd be a big one. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. He's tackled in the open field. Nice gain as he works the right side. Tackle around the 20-yard line. Here he goes. Touchdown, and they take the lead. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A four-play, 47-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Makes it out to about the 39. Taken down around the 49-yard line. He might have a chance. Makes it to the 37.
That makes it
first and 10.
Mike 55! Mike 55!
Check! Check! Dance! Dance!
Shift! Watch the shift!
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain of four on the play.
Roger, Roger.
That makes it second and six.
Mike 55. Eat. Check, check. Dance,
check. Check, check.
And he just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 27. Throws complete, big loss. That's a 7-yard loss.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
That'll bring up fourth and 13.
Quick throw. They'll bring him down at the 31. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Texas is up by four. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That makes it 7-6.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
86 yards. Third
down.
He's at midfield. And he's finally taken down at the 28. They come out in a 5-wide set. Here's an opening. And he's tackled at about the 17-yard line. And he hits him hard at the 20-yard line.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
From the 20-yard line, it's second down. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Knocked out of bounds around the 10-yard line.
Let's go. Mike Moore. Mike Moore.
That makes it third and three.
Tackle made at about the 15-yard line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
Fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Texas is up four. He gets it up, and he got it. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Taken from the 3-yard line. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Dives forward.
That makes it 2.
5 guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's going to be sacked for a loss. They really need to pick up this third and long here in the fourth quarter.
Get
would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it.
It's a great series here for the defensive side. They know they've got the upper hand right now late in this game.
He's at midfield, and he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. Fires out to his wideout. Texas is up seven. Spread the field with five wide. Oh, and a huge drop by the wideout here in the fourth quarter. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12. Straight up the middle, and he'll lose yardage. Is out to the tailback on the screen. They bring him down in the backfield. They'll call on the field goal unit here.
That'll make it fourth and 14.
Kicks up, and the field goal is good. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. From their own 25-yard line, second down. Shot to the tailback and threw his hands. He dives and he'll be marked down. He scrambled. And he's taken down at the 46.
That's a gain of 8 on that play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. His left gets it out to the halfback, and down he goes, right around the 46-yard line.
Hey, watch the ball, watch the ball. Easy, back five, back five, blue 40.
Throws to the tailback, incomplete. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. He's in trouble. Breaks one, and he hauls it in. He's at the 30, brought down at the 24. Scrambling. And they got him.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
This is the 9th play of this drive. go with a screen here. The halfback's got it.
That's a great tackle at the 23-yard line.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. And once again, the coach has decided to go for it on fourth down. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Throws it out there.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
9 times out of 10, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it. Last drive resulted in a field goal. And the offense will come back out looking to do one better. Nice run, and he's brought down. The Sooners taking their first time out of the half. It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on the 28. And they make the stop around the 31-yard line. Oklahoma's going to have to use their second time out of the half. He airs it out. The Sooners using their third and last timeout. That's a first down as they hooked up on the deep route.
And the defender just got outrun and outplayed by the receiver. He wanted it more, and that allowed him to make a heck of a play.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Hands it to the back. He makes his way to about the 18. The offensive fireworks are finally over, but it took the final gun to end it. Texas 78, Oklahoma 68. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Nothing adds to the pageantry of college football more than a good rivalry. This was a great game that should only add more fuel to the fire for next year's matchup, and boy, was it fun to watch.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.